Hey guys, it's been a long while. I feel like I haven't done a video in a long while. Let's see. Today I actually uploaded some Lost Odyssey playthrough videos. But they were like, I recorded those like quite a long time ago. And then the last one I uploaded before that was my video talking about how I got hired by Champion Learning Center. But that was also recorded like a month ago. So it's been a long while. And, you know, YouTubing has always been kind of in the back of my mind for some reason. It's just like, I want to make a video, but it's weird. It's kind of like, it's like I want to do it, but I'm never in the mood for it kind of thing. So there's just always this urge to kind of like, I want to make a video or record a video, but I'm not in the mood. And things have been getting a little bit more, I don't know, it's a little bit more messy right now. There's a lot more outlets that I'm participating in now than before. I recently restarted Facebook and Twitter, even though, you know, back, what, like 2 or 3 years ago? I think it was only like a year and a half ago, but it feels like 3 years ago. You know, I made a video saying why I got disillusioned and saying that, like, oh, I'm not going to Twitter, I'm not going to Facebook anymore, but I'm back with that, so there's that outlet. And also, I'm kind of acting as a freelance writer, kind of thing. It sounds fancy, freelance writer, but it's not really much. I just have a site, an account. So there's this called associated content that I write. That I have an account there, and I just kind of write. And depending on how many views I get, I actually get paid. But because, you know, I'm an amateur at that stuff, so I get paid really, really ridiculously low. It's like $2 a month. Yeah, but I mean, getting paid any money is good for me. So I do that, and then, I don't know, I'm crazy. So I'm tweeting a lot, and I also am blogging a lot, actual writing blogging, on a WordPress account that I got. And I'm back being active, kind of, on GameTrailers.com account. So there's a whole bunch of different outlets going on. And while I was kind of messing around with that, I wasn't really sure what I would do with this YouTube channel. There were a lot of different things that I kind of thought about. Didn't think about too fully, but kind of maybe considered. I was like, man, do I want to have it so that, you know, I start having separate channels for different kind of content? Like, do I want to have a channel just where I talk about my life? And do I want to have a channel that just I just talk about games? Things like that. And then I thought, you know, that's too much work for me. And also, that makes it feel like I'm doing something like this is my job. And you know, YouTube is one of those things. It's the oldest online account that I've had. So this is the oldest account I have. And not only that, it's something that I just do. There really is no reason behind what I do. I don't really care about views on YouTube. I don't really care who subscribes to me. I don't really care, you know, like that doesn't matter to me because I know I make no money on this and I really don't willing to make any money on this. I'm not willing to sell anything. You know, many other things, like say the writing for associated content, that's like, I'm not directly selling it, but in a way, because I'm getting paid through reviews, I'm selling what I wrote. You know, I'm selling myself in a way. It's just be like, if you like this article, favorite me and continue to follow more articles that I write. You know, it's kind of selling myself. It's kind of branding myself. And in a way, because I also connected it to my Twitter and Facebook and whatnot, those two, you know, Facebook and Twitter, kind of act as my, like, advertising kind of outlet. You know, it kind of links it. Although I'm not doing as much linking because I'm not doing much writing these days. But that's what it feels like. That, it feels like a job. Whereas I think YouTube, as far as, like, how I want this channel to be, what it wants being for me, I think it needs to not be a something that I sell, something that's going to sell me. I'm not selling anything here. So, to me, it is just an outlet. To just say whatever, and, you know, whatever I really want to upload, I think I could just do that here. Although most of it is gaming related, most of it is playthroughs, especially just, because I just got hooked on doing playthroughs these last couple of months. You know, I'll play a game, and nowadays, I play a game on, you know, on PS3 or something, and just like, man, you know, I can't, it doesn't feel like I'm fully actually, like, enjoying the experience unless I'm doing a playthrough, which is weird, because I like playthroughs because it allows me to critique every aspect of the game. You know, whereas if I do a review, I'm just picking out, this is what I liked, this is what I hated, and these are kind of things that I have a thought about. You know, I might have thoughts on, like, what this game means for the industry as a whole, what this game does for the industry. Like, does it push any new boundaries, or does it regress back and remind us of certain features that were just frustrating and annoying, and it came back? And also, what you know, that kind of thing, it's a good discussion to have on a specific game. But when I'm doing a playthrough, I'm showing the gameplay of the actual game. And, you know, a lot of it is unspoken, you know, like, I show it, so therefore you see it. And the way I do my playthroughs, I think it's not really a walkthrough, it's not a guide, although I'm really surprised at some of the comments I get on some of the playthroughs in which they did use it as part of a, like, a guide. They're like, you know, comments like, thanks for helping me out at this part. I'm just like, oh, okay, well, that's interesting, because in this particular video that you just watched, I struggled really hard. I, like, was stuck in a lot of parts, and I did a horrible job, but if that acted as a guide for you, then great. What my playthrough really is kind of, if you experience the game, you know, you can see my thoughts on those parts of the moments of the game. And if you haven't, and if you end up watching it, and most people don't, I only get like 1 or 2 views per video, which is, but like I said, I don't care about views. But if you do watch it, you know, it's kind of like, you know, you get to see what the game is like, and you get to see my thoughts on the game. So that's why I really like doing playthroughs, because I'm able to really showcase the entire game and really talk about my thoughts on the overall, on the whole product. You know, not just in the overall product, but just even down to the minute details of the product. So that's really what I like doing. And nowadays, when I want to talk about a game, it's just like I'm playing something. I'm just like, man, I should be doing a playthrough of this. But then again, it's like doing the video. That takes a certain amount of work. And I've been really lazy these past couple of months. So it's just like, don't want to do it. So recently, let's talk about the games I played, I guess. I played Killzone 3. I beat that on veteran difficulty at first. And then I was going through on Elite, but then I kind of stopped that. And I did a lot of online multiplayer. So I actually beat that without doing playthrough. I think the Killzone universe, this franchise, is something that I want to do a playthrough on, because those games are really just cool to showcase, like the levels. Although there isn't too much that I have comment on. Oh, my computer's running out of battery. Let me plug that in. You know, although the story aspects, I guess I could just talk a little bit about during the playthrough or whatever. But yeah, been playing Killzone. I do want to record just me playing Mag. Although, like, I suck at that game, but I just really, really enjoy playing it. I just really love the team aspect of playing Mag. And I don't know. I'm not really a big fan of FPS, and to me, like, that game is, like, kind of what keeps me, although I haven't been playing for a long while. But yeah, playthroughs are definitely in the works. And there's a lot of different games that I want to do a playthrough of. I think the first thing I'm going to do right after I beat Lost Odyssey, because I still haven't beat that game yet. That game just feels like such a chore. It's just like, oh, Lost Odyssey, gotta play that game. Not because, like, I enjoy playing it, but because I just gotta beat it, kind of thing. And I'm almost at the very end. And I think I got to the Grand Staff for the second time. And I think this is the final part. So I'm pretty much gonna be done with the game. I don't think I'm gonna go through the side quests or whatever, because that game just ain't doing it for me. Right now, I'm at the stage where I'm just playing it just to complete it, which is horrible. So, gonna get through that. The game I got through Gamefly, which, like, 3 weeks ago, tells you how much I haven't been gaming, was De Blob for Wii. So it's De Blob, right? I don't even know how to say it. It's De Blob for the Wii. And I'm definitely gonna want to do a playthrough on that. And then after that, I guess I get a bunch of games I own that I'd love to play again, just for doing the playthroughs, you know, just to give a good commentary, and also just to show the game off, like some of my favorite games, or whatever, or the games that I have. It's kind of interesting, my game collection, just because, like, you know, my main console is the PS3, and I played so many games on that system, but, like, most of the games I own seems to be PS3 exclusives. Which, I don't know how that turned out, because I know I had definitely had a lot of multi-platforms, so I guess I ended up selling a couple. I definitely do remember selling Fallout. Wait, did I ever own that? No, that was a rental. Never mind. Not Fallout. Oblivion. Yeah, Oblivion Game of the Year Edition. I had it. Don't know why I sold it, but I did. I'm kind of missing that. There are a couple of multi-platform ones that I had. I ended up selling it or whatever. I think I was really tight on money back, you know, and I needed something. And it was one of those moments like, I'm not going to be gaming. And, you know, I'm always wrong when I say that. So, that's what happened. The other things that's up with me. So, this channel-wise, I think I'm just going to kind of... Oh, that's another thing I talk about. So, this channel-wise, kind of what I was doing, I had it separated into different playlists of, you know, like my thoughts, which is communism, or gaming thoughts, which is gaming-related communism, and playthroughs. I would just have each playthrough as its own playlist, and then I would have movies, games, you know, stuff like that, and they're all on different playlists, and that's how this kind of channel was organized, and I just have so much stuff that I already wrote and talked about in, like, other sites, where there's a bunch of movies that I've watched, and I've never talked about them in any other outlet, so there's this archive of stuff. And I kind of wanted to act, my YouTube had acts, I kind of wanted my YouTube to act as like an archive of my thoughts on those different kind of products and different kind of thoughts I had. But now I have so many other outlets that archiving is becoming really hard for me. And that's why a lot of the game review videos that I upload are, you know, they're really old games. And they're kind of uploaded in an alphabetical order in a way. Because I'm just, you know, I already wrote about them, like, years ago. You know, on my Game Trailers account, you can find my written reviews. So they're already all written. It's just I'm trying to put them in video form and uploading them. So it's acting as kind of an archive. But then I'm thinking also, you know, to have my YouTube more as act as a video blog. You know, just kind of talk like this over what's going on with me, in a way, what I'm playing, what I'm watching, what I'm reading. And just kind of maybe acting as a daily update kind of thing. So in that way, doing videos isn't as kind of a commitment for me. It's not as hard, like, time-consuming and feels like work for me. And that way I can just keep, you know, uploading stuff out there. I mean, although it is definitely a really cool thing to, I think, have it organized in a way. So that I can... This is a video for this movie, what my thoughts on this movie. This is a video for my thoughts on this song. You know, I think that's something I'm going to be kind of striving for. But at the same time, you know, if I have thoughts, I guess I'll just be open to kind of just bring it out here as an update form. So there's different kinds of... So this is just a general brief over update video. You know, this isn't... I don't think this is a video where I'm actually going to discuss stuff. It's just telling you, like, what's been up and what's coming up, really. So it's kind of like this, like, you know, agenda kind of vlog. And what's been up? My life so far, I guess it's really good. As mentioned before, I'm a tutor now. I've been hired. I've been tutoring for about 3 weeks. And what it is, I tutor for this nonprofit company called Champion Learning Center. And Champion Learning Center provides tutoring to... eligible students, so kids who are low income, like they receive free lunches or are eligible for reduced or free lunches. They get free tutoring, 30 hours per year, and I go to their houses and I provide them one-on-one tutoring. So I currently have 8 students, and each student gets 2 hours per session and 2 sessions per week. So I'm working 32 hours a week. So that's currently my job. It pays $15 an hour, so if no one cancels or nothing happens, usually I make about, like, what, I don't know, $800 a week in 2 weeks, so $850 or so. So I'm making like $1,900 a month on this job, which is not bad. Not bad, except that I have like a huge college loan. So my college loan in total, and don't be surprised, and this is not an error, is about $104,000. Yeah, $104,000. That's not, you know, that's how big thing is. So that means I have to make like $864 of monthly payments. That's super hard on this salary, but it is kind of doable. It just means that I'm not going to be able to save any money any month, and I won't be able to donate as much to the colleges that I like to donate to. So that's just really what it means. Yeah, so that's what's been going on with me so far. I love the job. It's really, really rewarding to work with these kids and to, you know, but the whole job is probably another video in itself, just talking about my job as a tutor. But so far, that's been going on. Oh, I'm still waiting on the on my application for New York City Teaching Fellows. So they got back to me, like, 2 weeks ago, I think. And I got an email that was like, your decision is now changed. Your status is now changed. It is now pending. So their decision is pending, so I might have to wait till April to know if I got accepted into the program or not. And at this point, like, although when I first applied for this position, I was really kind of scared. It's like career shift, you know, it's a big deal. I think further and further on, like I really want this job. So I don't know. There's like a 50% chance that I don't get it, 50% chance that I do get it. Don't know. But if I do get it, that'd be, I think, it'd be pretty incredible, you know, just because then my future is kind of set. Right now, if I don't get that, then I'm back to, like, kind of square one. It's just like, where is my life going kind of deal, you know, and that's, I tell myself that I excel in swimming in uncertain waters, but who knows, I might be the type to drown in it, so. Don't know. That's life so far. As for like little minimal stuff, I guess, gaming wise, Killzone 3 on the PlayStation 3, you know, when I get the time, which isn't much nowadays, that's what I play a couple of times. And let's see. Oh, gaming. Also, I've been gaming on the iPhone a lot recently. And I got an iPhone recently too, which I wanted to do a video on that, but I didn't. So, been playing this game called, like, Infinity Blade, which is really cool. It uses the Unreal Engine, and it's made by Chair, the same guys that made Shadow Complex. Really, really, cool game, I guess. I just don't like the way the experience system is set up, how the experience points are distributed, and, certain aspects like that. I might do a review on Infinity Blade. Been trying out all these, like, social or free online games or whatever. Those are interesting, just not my type. I really hate games like that. Like, even on Facebook, I tried it out. Like, City Bill and Farm Bill. Yeah, totally not my alley. So there was something like that on the iPhone, too. And I was just like, wow, this type of game again, not into it. So that's on the gaming front. Although, a similar game like that actually kind of got me hooked was this. It's called, let me see what it's called. Oh, it's called World War. That's what it's called. And it's pretty much just like playing with statistics. You know, you raise units, you build defenses, you attack other online players, whatever. And since I have since it's an iPhone, I could really do it anywhere with, you know, it's just pretty cool. But yeah, that's been on the gaming front. On the book front is where I think right now is most interesting. I'm reading, The Outsider, by Richard Wright, and it's a really interesting book. Like, it's about this, like, black guy who, has to restart his life, because of some horrible situation that he's in, and, he gets into an accident, and everyone believes he's dead, but he's not. So he starts his life over with a new identity, and, it's a very, like, the writing is just brilliant in it because it poses so many interesting philosophical questions. Like, I think, like, more, it's not just a book on, like, race. It's not just a book on, like, what black people lived through in those times or what they are going through. But it's more than that. It's a book that really explores the nature of life and people and identity. And it's just really, really deep, really thought-provoking. And the main character is just, he's so unpredictable at times. And the reasoning that he makes for his actions is just like, it's like, oh, it's kind of like unnerving in a way. It's like, it's a hard guy to root for. In fact, a lot of times you're rooting against him because of his actions are so, Like, in a way, he puts it himself. He says he's thinking like a criminal. And in a way, in a lot of the parts of the book, he is. And so that's what makes the books, like, so fascinating. I think I'm halfway through. I'm at page, like, 250. And the book is about, like, what, 580 pages long or something. So I'm reading that. And I'm also reading this book called, it's probably going to be backward. Yeah, it's going to be backward. But it's called Eating Animals by Jonathan Safran. It really goes into the whole philosophy of what it means to eat animals. What it means to be a omnivore or a carnivore, for that matter. And, I had to stop at, like, page 52 or something because it was just too much. Because at the second section, it starts becoming... So he starts kind of introducing his story through, like, in a memoir type of way. And then by the second part, he's just alphabetically listing words. And he's just kind of not defining them, but discussing the words. So the first word, of course, is animal. And then the second word is anthropocentrism, then anthropodenial, anthropomorphism, battery cage. I think that's the section that, like, made me almost quit reading. And then broiler chickens. Bullshit is one of the words. Bycatch. CAFO, which is concentrated animal feeding operation, also known as factory farm. CFE, which is common farming exemptions, and comfort food. So comfort food is where I stopped, where I was just like I cried. So, like, it was too much. Like, it wasn't the book, but it was just me thinking too much about what was being said in there, in the topics. And I was just like, I cried. I was like, I can't read anymore. I'm too upset, too sad. So stop reading at that on at Eating Animals. And wow, this video is super long, and now it's time for me to go and tutor. So I think I'll end it here. And who knows what this YouTube channel will become. But that's the update for today. Talk to you guys later.